Hey guys, Rolando Rodriguez here with xgains.com, where we got workouts that work, eats that satisfy, and everything else you need to reach your lifestyle goals. Talking about when to and when not to listen to your body. Now, this is crucial. Not listening to your body can be the difference between no gains and massive gains, between staying where you are and making personal best. But on the flip side, right? Not listening to your body can be the difference between massive injury and staying in the game. So it's very important to learn to listen to your body. Now, when should we listen to our body? I think there's mainly two times we should do so. The first pretty much goes without saying, but we gotta talk about it because a lot of people out there just do pretty stupid things. If you're injured, you need to listen to your body. Now, I've had two major shoulder issues of both, you know, the labrum and the bicep tendon. There were things that my body was scared to do. Mentally, I said, you know what? It just doesn't feel right, and I didn't do it. You need to listen to your body. It'll tell you what you can and cannot do. Don't be a chicken attempt to do certain things and pull out or stop if you think you need to. Your body is smarter than you are. Let it tell you what to do. The second time you need to listen to your body is if you're walking into the gym or you wake up in the morning and your muscle tells you, hey man, I wanna work out. Not if you wanna work out the muscle, that is totally different. There's times where you're gonna wake up in the morning and you're gonna say, you know what, today was leg day, but my muscles, my arms are telling me they wanna work out. Take advantage of that. You feel strong that day. You're probably gonna reach personal best doing whatever you're doing if the muscle is telling you it wants to work out. If you're telling the muscle you wanna work it out just because you don't wanna work out another set of muscles, that's not what I'm talking about. So pretty much there's two times you wanna listen to your body. One's injury, of course, and the other is when your muscles are telling you they wanna work out, not when you want to work out your muscles because you wanna have bigger arms. That's not what I'm talking about. Now, let's talk about the times you don't want to listen to your body. You don't want to listen to your body if it's telling you, you know what, I feel a little bit sore. So what? Here's the thing, there's a difference between soreness and injury. Now, sometimes an injury can feel a little sore, and you know what, you need to learn to tell your body, let's find out what it is. So you wake up and your body's like, oh, I'm a little bit sore, my legs are sore, or a lot bit sore. And today's leg day, you know what? I don't care. Actually, there's some workout routines and workout regimen that suggest that when a body part is sore, you should actually activate that body part to get nutrition and oxygen and everything else that's good to heal the area. You want to plump blood to it as opposed to letting it stay still. As a matter of fact, when you injure yourself, most physical therapists say, try to maintain mobility, move it as much as it lets you. Actually releasing synovial fluid into the joints and all the and the cartilage actually helps the cartilage repair itself and the joints feel better. That's a topic we'll talk about later. So what I'm saying is, if you wake up sore, don't skip the workout. As a matter of fact, find out what it is. Don't let your body trick you into not working out. If you can't tell whether or not it's hurt or sore, try to work out, and the workout's gonna tell you whether or not it's sore or hurt. Now, another time you don't wanna listen to your body is if you walk into a gym and you're not really feeling the workout. Not feeling the workout is not an excuse not to do it. Not liking legs is not an excuse not to do it. Don't allow your lack of motivation for a workout to be the reason why you're not doing that workout. If your body's telling you, let's do something else just because we don't like this exercise, no. Don't listen to your body. Tell it to shut up and get through the workout. Another reason not to listen to your body is if you're feeling a bit sick, slightly sick, not big time sick. What I do is, if I feel that I'm starting to get sick, I say, you know what? This may turn into something big or it's gonna stay something small, but I better get my workouts in now while I can so that when I do get sick, I can have those days off. So you wake up, you feel 80%, you go, and you know what? By the time you end up finishing that workout, you might feel 95% or 100%. Just like when you wake up with a sore throat sometimes, you're like, oh, I'm gonna call in to work, and you know what? It's just the drainage through the night. As you get moving, you're gonna feel better as your body starts to wake up. And doing exercise can do just that. You wake up, you feel a little sick, you know what? You better take advantage of the fact that you feel 80% because tomorrow you might wake up and feel 30%. To learn not to listen to your body is something you have to train your body to do. And a perfect example of this is Julio Franco, who used to be a utility player for the Braves. Swole guy, lasted till his like mid-40s, the epitome of fitness. Well, his trainer would actually tell him sometimes, hey, you know what? Tomorrow, we're going to do your favorite workout. Let's say it was chest. So, Franco, tomorrow, we're going to do chest. So, Franco comes in all day, mindset, I'm doing chest, I'm doing chest, I'm doing chest. Gets there, and his trainer says, we're doing legs. Boom! If it was me, I'd punch him in the face. I mean, I don't know if you guys are like me, but all day, you know, from when I finish a workout one day till the next day that I know what I'm going to do, I'm already psyching myself up and I'm pumping my body up to do that workout the next day, right? So if you walk in and then you switch it on yourself, you know, sometimes you have no choice. You walk into the gym and you wanted to use an equipment and there's 35 people in line to use that equipment. And you're like, oh, got to do something else. You know what? Intentionally make that happen sometimes. Intentionally make yourself do something that you weren't planning to do. Get a friend to say, hey, call me up one day next week. You don't know when that guy's gonna call you up. And when he does, that's the day that you do a different workout, even if it's doubling up on the workout that you did the previous day. But you switch up your workout from what you were gonna do to something new when that friend calls you. And that way it's truly spontaneous, right? Another thing that he would do is say, hey, we're gonna work out at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. And then he'd show up at Franco's house at freaking 3 a.m. in the morning, wake up his body and shock it. We're going to go work out now. Are you kidding me? No, right now. You think his body wanted to wake up? He thought he was going to work out at 7 p.m. All of a sudden, he's working out at 3 a.m. in the morning. The trainer's training his body to keep it guessing so that it doesn't plateau. And at the same time, he's training Julio Franco's body to say, you know what? There are no limits on what we can do. We don't have to listen to what our body's telling us because our mind knows that we can make the body do whatever we want it to do. Now, mind you, if you're injured, listen to it. But make sure that you're injured. And that's the point of all this. Learning not to listen to your body will actually allow you to learn to listen to it even more. To be more in tune with it, to actually start to have a conversation with your body and get that mind-muscle connectivity that you need to actually develop your body the way you want to develop it. Recap, two times I think you should listen to your body are if you're injured and when your muscles are telling you they want to work out. That's different than when you're telling your muscles you want to work them out. When not to listen to your body, right? A couple of examples there. When you're feeling just sore. If you're just sore, I don't care. Work out, pump blood to that area, watch it recover, watch it recuperate, give it the nutrition that it needs, and you're gonna feel better by the end of it. If you're not really feeling a workout, so what? Don't switch it up just because you're not really feeling it. Learn to find the motivation to make the workout happen and make the intensity be there while you're working out, even though you don't really like that workout. Third time not to listen to your body is if you're sick or feeling a little bit sluggish. If you're 80%, go for it, because tomorrow you might wake up at 30% and you won't be able to work out. Or as a matter of fact, you might wake up tomorrow feeling even better and you just skipped the workout because you were 80%. And finally, train your body to not listen to your body, because by not listening, you'll actually be listening even better. That's it for now. Let us know if you got any comments or questions down below. This is Rolando Rodriguez with xgain.com. That's X dash, not the word, but the symbol dash.com. I hope you guys have a fantastic week. Peace.